Up to now, we have learned only a handful of named distributions. In this video, we expand our named distribution arsenal to include the beta distribution. The beta distribution will be our best friend when you have Bernoulli or binomial data and you want to specify a prior for the success probability. So say goodbye to the uniform prior for theta and say hello to a beta prior for theta. The beta is a two-parameter distribution whose parameters in the computer world are called shape 1 and shape 2, and in the math world they're often referred to as alpha and beta. Really strange to have a beta parameter for a beta distribution, but that's how it goes. I'm going to show my workflow for learning about a new distribution and using it to express my prior uncertainty. First stop in my workflow is Wikipedia. I get the support. The support is between 0 and 1. Makes sense that we use this to model a probability, as probabilities are between 0 and 1. Next step, figure out the meaning of the parameters. There's two parameters, alpha and beta, but figuring out their meaning takes some digging. First, I could look at the example PDFs, the density functions, and see how they can spread plausibility around the support. Also, take notice of the mean and the alternate parameterization section, as they will often be helpful. I will touch on some of the content of those areas during this video. I might then use stat function in ggplot to play with some parameters. Here's what I can tell you about the two parameters of the beta distribution. First off, when both parameters are set to 1, we have a uniform distribution. This spreads plausibility equally over all possibilities. Next thing to know is that you can think of alpha as the number of successes you have already observed, and think of beta as the number of failures you have observed. So as you increase alpha, success probability rises. Here we go from beta 1-1 to a beta 4-1 distribution, and the plausible region shifts to areas of greater and greater success probability. Another thing to note about the beta distribution is that the mean success probability is equal to alpha divided by alpha plus beta. In this case, the mean is 80%, and this indicates our prior belief that probabilities around 80% are more plausible. If we want to increase the strength of our belief, we can increase alpha and beta, but maintain their ratio. Here we move to a beta 8.2, where the mean is still 80%, but the narrower density curve indicates values farther away from 80% have become less plausible. Recall that interpreting the parameters is like having seen that many observations of successes and failures. So in this case, we are starting from prior knowledge, analogous to having seen 8 previous successes and 2 previous failures. The sum of these two parameters is called the concentration of the beta distribution, and is sometimes represented by the Greek letter kappa. We can increase kappa to 100 or even 1000. While keeping the mean constant, but that really would be overconfidence as a prior. Typically, we are looking for a posterior because we lack confidence in a good estimate. So I rarely let my prior concentration be greater than 10. Given that, let's return to our beta 8.2 distribution. Now, if we are happy with our concentration parameter of 10, we can adjust alpha and beta to reflect different mean plausibility estimates. Beta 7.3 would have a mean plausibility of 70%, beta 6.4 would have a mean plausibility of 60%, and beta 5.5 would have a mean plausibility of 50%. One of my favorite prior distributions keeps the mean at 50%, but lowers the concentration. It is the beta 2.2 distribution. Let's move to that here. This is a distribution that is open to any number between 0 and 1, with the exception of 0 and 1. It puts a very mild preference for success probabilities near 50%, but will easily allow the data to shift the plausibility to lower or higher values. Imagine we observe 6 failures in a row with this prior. So that puts our posterior to beta 2,8. We simply added the 6 failures to the prior beta parameters to get this posterior. And that's the beta distribution, a great prior for unknown Bernoulli success probabilities, something that is useful everywhere from political polling to clinical trials of medicines and vaccines. It's a very relevant distribution.